So now we've gotten to what's pretty much the holy grail of acid-base chemistry, and that is predicting acid-base equilibrium. All right, so let's go ahead and get started on this. For these types of questions, what you're going to be asked is, what's the direction of the reaction? Is it going to go to the right or is it going to go to the left? And even though it sounds like, hey, I've got a 50-50 shot, it can't be that bad, they are surprisingly tricky. Okay, so we're going to learn a set of rules and we're going to use pKa information in order to figure out these questions. All right, so basically, here's, I'm just going to give you an example. Here's a common question that you could see on an exam. Would the following reaction go to the left or would it go to the right? Label all the species, draw the correct arrows. Okay, there's a lot in there and there's a lot that you have to understand. So let's go ahead and break it down one step at a time. The very first thing that you always want to start off with is identifying the Lewis acid and the Lewis base. Remember that I said Lewis is the most general definition of acids and bases, right? So that just means that you're just going to find on the left-hand side which one is the acid and which one is the base, okay? Now, how do you do this? A lot of times that can be the trickiest part. Well, many times there's going to be known charges or a known acid will be present. So if there's charges or a known acid, that makes it easy. So for example, if you see a positive charge, that's always going to be the acid. And if you see a negative charge, that's always going to be the base. Okay? So that part is easy. Or also, let's say that you have like a carboxylic acid. If you have a carboxylic acid, then that would make it easy as well. Or if you have HCl or whatever. Okay? But sometimes you're not going to have a negative charge and you're not going to have a positive charge. So if you don't, then you go to the second step. The second step is to make sure that all spectator ions are dissociated. Do you guys remember spectator ions from Gen Chem? Those were just your first column cations. So that would be lithium positive, potassium positive, and sodium positive. Okay? Now, some professors even go as far as to add cesium. Okay, I have seen that before. Cesium is also in that first column. All right, so these actually, I mean, I know that I said that it was three, but it's actually, it could be four, depending on how tricky your professor wants to get. These are cations that always dissociate in solution. So these basically make ionic bonds. So for example, if I had NaOH, and I was trying to determine if that was my acid or my base, I would be confused possibly because I would say, well, I don't see a negative charge. I don't see a positive charge. What is it? Well, you have to dissociate it first. So what that means is you have to take this and make it Na positive, and that means my OH becomes OH negative. And now, remember that Na positive is a spectator ion, so I don't care about it. So that means that now I have a base. Does that make sense? So you have to, if you don't see an obvious positive or a negative, you have to go ahead and start dissociating. Okay? But now let's say that you do both of those steps and your compounds are both still neutral. So let's say there's nothing to dissociate, there's no charges, you have no clue what to do. So for example, if you had something like, let me think of a good example. So let's say that you had, H2O, okay? And you were comparing it to carboxylic acid and you didn't remember that carboxylic acid was an acid. So let's just say that you had a brain fart and you forgot that carboxylic acid was an acid. Well, then you could just go ahead and look at pKa's. So then you could say, that's basically the next rule. If they're still neutral, assign the lowest pKa as the acid, okay? So then I would say the pKa of my water is 16, the pKa of my carboxylic acid is 5, so that means that my carboxylic acid is gonna be the acid, and that means that my water is gonna be the base. Does that make sense? So basically, if you are still neutral at the end, just go with the lowest pKa. Cool? So that's going to really take care of you, okay? The next step is, now that you know what your acid and your base are, go ahead and label the conjugates. That means draw them out, if you have to draw them, or just label them based on which one is the acid. That one becomes the conjugate base. The base becomes the conjugate acid. Cool. So then the last step is compare the acidity, or pKa, basically acidity and pKa are the same thing, of the Lewis acid to the conjugate acid, okay? And remember that in order to go in that direction, you're going to have to go from stronger to weaker, okay? Now, one way I like to say that is that the strongest acid is going to be the one with the lowest pKa. So I always say that the pKa should go from lower on the right I mean on the left, to higher on the right. pKa, because remember pKa is the opposite of strength. So you want a low pKa to start with and you want a high pKa at the end. Okay?